Good morning, Emmanuel. My name is Treasure Hutchinson, and I'm here to do a brag on God. I've done multiple brag on Gods, whether it be with Emmanuel prayer groups, whether it be about voter registration, whether it be about my own life. But here we are, and today I'm doing a special brag on God. The brag on God I'm doing today is to honor my mother, Dr. Lorraine K. Hutchinson. This will be very challenging, but it's also going to be very much of an honor to be her daughter and to do this brag on God. As most of you may or may not know, my mother, Dr. Lorraine K. Hutchinson, passed away on Saturday, December 3rd. I decided to do this. Joe actually reached out to me and asked me if I would do this. Everyone knows I like to be on camera, but this is very, very different. But I know my mother would say, of course, Treasure, you're going to do this. You love a challenge. And I'm thinking, why am I doing this? Why can't I just grieve in silence? But what I realize is that sometimes we're going through things. It's not just me going through this, or my father, Chester, going through this, or even my brother, Reggie, my twin brother, Brace, going through this. It's all of us, because we're all going through something right now. We are in a time of a season when everybody has something going on. The holidays can be very, very difficult. So if you guys would allow me to tell you a little bit about my mother, you may or may not know. She met my father in 1969 at Santa Clara University, August 10th to be exact. They fell in love immediately. In 1975, they wed, and in 1976, my brother, Reginald Hutchinson, my twin, and myself were born. I'm 3 minutes older, by the way, so technically I am the oldest child. My mother raised us to be resilient and adventurous and to take on a challenge. After that, in 1986, my mother opened up her own private practice. Now, in 1986, for an African-American woman to open up a private practice was unheard of. But not just any old private practice, a therapy practice with dealt with marriage, family, and child therapy, Christian, as an African-American woman. At that time, African-Americans weren't known to go to therapy. Heck, most of us never went to therapy. Men, women, no matter what race you are, but she believed in the cause. Later on in 2000, she went on to get her doctorate from California Coast University in psychology. My mom believed in education, but not just in education, but she believed in helping others. My mom taught for 20 plus years at Western Seminary. What type of person actually teaches pastors and reverends and counselors at a seminary, which means she knew the word? But my mom didn't just know the word. You could give her any type of scripture and she can recite it by memory. She was like a human encyclopedia. Oh, for millennials, that was a Google back in the day. My mother was brilliant. She was a genius, but she was a lover of the Lord. As a family unit of four, we were all so very, very close. But because she was a matriarch of the family, she challenged us to always do our best. Even though it wasn't a direct challenge, it was always a challenge with her. My mother believed in marriage. She believed in God. She believed in being a mother. I leave for you today one of her favorite scriptures, and it says, Philippians 4:6, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. So everyone, I'd like to leave you today on behalf of my father, Chester, my brother Reginald and his wife Gina, my husband Thomas, and myself. We like to say thank you. We appreciate you. We love you. We thank you for your prayers and your concerns, but we know that she is with the Lord above. So anyone that's going through a difficult time in this season, understand they're going to be okay. But guess what? We're also going to be okay. Continue to pray. Continue to use your family and your church family members, because together we'll get through this. Everyone, my name is Treasure Hutchinson, and happy holidays.